Today we'll do the encapsulation of the solar cells. We'll use the same substance, use it for fixing the post-contact issue as seen in the previous video. We pour the plastosil M2000 into this cup until we have measured 150 grams with this scale. Now we'll add into the same cup the catalyst OL1. We already measured 10 milliliters of the catalyst in this syringe. And we pour it into the cup. Normally it is added 8% of the catalyst to the mixture, but in this case we needed to extend the curing time a little bit. It takes more time to place the cells in its correct place without damaging them, so we use less catalysts, only 10 milliliters. Now we are showing the glass on which we'll place the solar cells. This is a square meter template glass that has width of 4 milliliters. The mixture should be well mixed so the catalyst endures the silicon. After mixing it well for around 3 to 5 minutes continuously, you can spread it all over the glass surface like we're doing here. We will do this as quick as possible because the curing time is happening with the silicon and we need some time to play with the cells a little bit, like you'll see here. We are spreading the silicon using gloves to cover all the glass surface. Try to not leave any area without silicon. This mixture should be homogeneous spread on all surface. Using our own hands makes us ensure that the areas are equally covered with the same amount of silica. Be quick on this process to avoid sticking it too early in the areas that you don't need. Okay? Now we'll begin to put the cells first row. Before we put the cells under the silicon, verify if the cell surface is totally clean, because some waste or dust on the cells can cause performance problems or cracks. We'll press lightly the cells and adjust the space between them. Pay attention to not press it too less or too much. If you press too much, the cell will crack. And if you press less than needed, you won't have the desired effect. So the first row is done. Now we will put the second row of the solar cells. And here it is, the second row. In the first row we have the positive side, and in the second row we have the negative side. We have made a string of cells in series, so every positive side of the string needs to be connected to the negative side of the next string and so on. We place the third row of the cells that has the positive side. Now the fourth row of solar cells, the fifth row of the solar cells here, and finally the sixth row of cells, which is the last one. Now we are adjusting the cells so they are aligned properly. Do it with special care because it can break the cell, can cause some tension between them, and weld contacts between can be compromised. So be gently in this task. Take special attention on the space that is needed for the buzz wire. On the top you need 3 centimeters. And on the bottom, only 1 centimeter. The next step is placing these squares at each corner and in the middle of the solar cell. Now, we need to perform this quick because the curing time is happening at the same time. We prepared this before and cut squares to place 5 units on each cell. It is made of cork and sponge with 2 centimeter size. Usually, it is used during transportation of glasses to split piles of them. After having filled all cells with these sponge squares, the idea is to make the cells compressed between the glass and the silicone as much as possible in order to avoid air between them. After this, we'll place another glass. So, this makes better adherence of the solar cells to the glass. And it seems finished. Right now, we are just adjusting the sponge to the corners where it's usually less cohesive, and it's done. Now we'll place another glass on the top. We already made the other solar panel with the other 36 solar cells, and it looks like this. Now we'll place that solar panel already made on the top of the solar panel we already built in order to press it and make better contact and adherence of the solar cells to the silicon and the glass. Then we cover the solar panels with a linen to avoid dust. And at home, we can use these water carboys to press the solar panels during the curing time. Now, we'll put water carboy here and another there and another one over here. And finally, the last one here, and it's fine. All solar panel area is covered with these weights. So, after the curing time of one day, we take out the weights and can split one solar panel from the other. We take out the linen, and this looks good. That's a good-looking solar panel. Now we will remove the sponge squares, but first we take out the solar panel, yes, and this looks good because most of them are under the upper glass, and that is great because it means that the silicone didn't stick to the parts, and if it was glued, we needed to remove it, and that's a not easy task. Solar cells were fixed to the tempered glass due to the silicone application and curing. Now we flip the solar panel to the front side and check if there is areas where more silicone is needed. We can see here and there that is needed more silicone. Only to the areas that are needed, we take a bit of paper, hand design the solar cells and mark the areas in which we visibly see it needs more silicon. This way, we'll avoid using more silicon to areas that are already filled with silicon properly, and we can have a clear view where it is needed. Otherwise, we will be lost, like we were in the past. Now, you can mark every area in the panel that needs more silicon. We can see there is some. It's very difficult to not have some areas. How the process is handmade, and if you put more silicon in the first place, when you compress it, it can stick the sponge squares, and it is more dangerous glue on glass. That's why we use it 150 grams of silicon at the first place. Now we will mix 54 grams of ballasto seal and 4 grams of the catalyst OL1. In this case, we use only 4 grams of the catalyst, so the curing time is quicker. This is the idea. Quick curing so we can continue our task. After mixing it very well, we'll put on the areas that we marked on paper as the areas that need it. We'll mix it well. So, like you see here, the draw helps. We will begin in this free cells. I'm putting a little bit. Pay attention that if you put enough silicon in order to fulfill the gaps, you can press slightly the cell in that area so the silicon can move inside the gap. Be very careful in this task because you can break the cell. The next part of the cells that will put more silicon is the contact part between cells. Normally, this part needs more layer of silicon to promote a full isolation to the environment. Here, we'll put the silicon in the poles area of each cell and spread the mixture all over cells. Just spray the silicon and make sure that have enough quantity. Then after the curing time, you don't feel the contact, only the silicon. This is very important that all cells are fully isolated from the environment. First, because of your safety, don't forget you are making an energy generator. So, if you have enough voltage, that can kill you. Two panels of this can make near 50 volts, and this can kill you. We just use the excess of silicon to begin covering all cells. As we are doing here, we are covering all cells. And it looks fine. In time, we begin the task of welding the buzz wire over here. We use this small screwdriver to push the tab wire up because some of them stick to the silicon. In some of them, it is necessary also to remove a little bit of silicon. We use this buzz wire to connect each two string of cells. We already cut by size the needed tab wire. In order to weld the tab wire up with the buzz wire in the cells, we use this 60 watt iron and something. We use the screwdriver also to help the welding process. We just try to make the buzz wire as close as possible to the cell because we don't have so much space for that. We just weld the first one, and now we are going to weld the second one here, third one here, and the last one here in first cell, and now we pass to second cell. Keep on welding here. We'll mix more 50 milliliters of silicon and we'll spread it all over the panel. The idea is to cover all the cells with it in order to promote a good isolation. Just spread it out and make sure that all cells have a good coverage. We prefer to put small quantities and multiple layers and wait the curing time between layers. For the isolation of the buzz wire, we use Plastoseal M60. Sure, we can use the same in all the cells, but we have this one and we'd like to try. It is lightweight and has a high viscosity. Use the same catalysts and the same quantity. We mix it very well and we spread it in the contact parts of the buzz wire, and also covering the tab wire and the cell corners. We use claw pegs in order to be sure the buzz wire is stable and closer to the glass as much as possible. We also use multiple layers to make the isolation. As you can see on the edge of the solar panel. And it's done! We already finished the solar panel. Thank you for watching. In the next video, we'll show these panels working at roof and other installation details. Bye!